here we are at the Delta stand, and I'm with Shane Arnold, who we've got to know each other quite a bit lately. Yes. Even though you're in that far away place.
The Republic of West Australia, we call it.
The Republic of West Australia. All about this system here, understanding what the, what are we calling it, the Rural Electrification System?
It is a bit of a tongue twister. We probably have to review it. Rural Electrification Solution.
Solution, that's solution, right, solution. Yeah. Now, what is the solution? What is it providing?
So we're getting a lot of information coming from our clients. They're telling us that for grid connections, we've got single or split phase, three phase quality issues. Plus, obviously we know that the off-grid market is just booming. So rather than just say we're an off-grid product, we're going to take grids, generators, solar, many power delivery options, and give it to you in the beast, as you call it, the box.
I better trademark that one.
Yeah.
How is it different from a normal kind of inverter and battery solution?
Yeah, it's very modulated. So we have a product that we call a rectiverter.
You've got one just here.
Yep. Yeah, brought that in for you. So being modular, this is a 1.2 kilowatt AC output. Okay, we can also deliver 800 watts of DC at 48 volts, but it will take in both 48 volt DC, the 230 volt AC, and put the same out again. And yeah, it's a great little product to be able to do both there.
So this is the 1.2 kilowatt rectiverter. Gee, what's
1.7 kilos.
1.7 kilos.
Easy to air freight should you need to.
And looking at the back of it, this looks like you could just plug it in.
Just slides in. I believe these are our earthing spots here. So once they're in, they connect up. And once that's in, the system will recognize it, commission it, provision, and it just gets working.
It sounds like you don't need a lot of training to install one of these.
No, so the idea is, as we know in a lot of these rural settings, truck rolls a high cost. The idea is that remote hands can remove and replace hot swappable, nice and easy with no tools.
I love this term, remote hands. So you're in your office operating these?
Yeah, so the idea is we should be able to control the whole system digitally,
wow,
remotely.
Yep.
And we should just be able to explain to someone on the phone,
yep,
remove this, swap that, flick this, flick that. So remote hands is what we coined that.
And we've got these little wings here, which you, yep, put a screwdriver in and they pop out?
Just a pen, actually.
Pen?
Yeah, just a pen. We'll pop the arms and that will allow you to remove it.
Wow.
And when you put them back in, it locks it in place.
So it's perfectly safe to unplug it when it's operating?
Yes, it's hot swappable.
Right, yeah. Wow, that's awesome. So 1.2 kilowatts each, but we've got a lot of them, so you can build a bigger system.
Yeah, so we can start at 1.2 kilowatts. You might want someone that wants 6 kilowatts. You sell them a system with 6 kilowatts worth of these, they want more, send them a new one, hot upgradable. Slide it in and boom, we've got another 1.2 kilowatts of AC available.
Right. Is there kind of like a time frame, like they change every year, the models are different?
No, we've been using this for quite some time and it's going to be around for quite a lot longer.
Well, that's a plus because, you know, people are often caught out by this upgradability clause of,
yep,
while we still make it.
Mm-hmm.
But you've been in this, or Eltec have been in the market for a long time making rectiverters. So.
Yeah, and what we need to understand is rural electrification is a part of our business model, but telco power supplies is very big.
Yep.
So to go and change form factors and not make it retrospectively upgradable to any new models would just be crazy. So
right,
if we do come out with a new model, it will be retrospectively applied.
Now there's one with a yellow fan on the front.
Yes.
Is this just like a different colour option?
Yellow for our sunshine.
Oh, really?
So this is our 3.2 kilowatt maximum power point tracker charge controller.
Yep.
So, you know, 9 to 10 panels into this.
Wow, that's grunty. 3.2 yep, kilowatts in the same, basically 1.7 kilo unit.
It's the same form factor, yeah.
Yeah. So these things love solar, which is kind of what you want in rural settings. It's,
yes,
lots of solar.
Yep. Absolutely, and you can just spec it, keep adding more and more to add more and more solar, and they're fed the solar panels into the cabinet from the base and will plug into pre-wired MC4 connections and switching ready to go.
Yeah, I noticed in the unit here behind us, it's got eight MPPT inputs.
If you want more, Glenn, we can give you more.
Right.
If you want more, that's not hard.
So this is actually a flexible chassis that you can arrange to suit the customer's requirements.
So this chassis, we've got configured at 14.4 kilowatts AC with around 25 kilowatts of solar, and that same cabinet here, we can go all the way to 43.2 kilowatts with 35 kilowatts of solar,
yep,
all in this one cabinet.
Wow. Let's talk about the batteries, but I'm not going to hold one because,
sure,
I think it might be a little problematic.
Yeah, yeah, they're up there. So these are a Polarium battery, and we have a long-standing relationship with Polarium. We have a global arrangement with them, and the benefit of this is we supply you the battery, and it's all warranted and supported by us in Australia.
So. All right, so there's no little battles with the, you know, inverter company versus the battery companies pointing the fingers, it's your problem, it's your problem.
When developing the product, we researched everything we had done in the field in the past,
yep,
and worked towards what is successful. this is a successful combination. We know that, and with many other factors that we've brought in here, ensures that we got maximum reliability.
And they come in different sizes?
So their physical form factor is the same. Mm-hmm. They all put out 4.8 kilowatts of power, and then your capacity is different. So we can do 2.4 kilowatt hours, 4.8, 7.2, 9.6, or 12.9 kilowatt hours, all in the same form factor.
Oh, wow, okay.
Yep.
So it's, what is it, a 4RU?
It's 4RU. Yep. So in this cabinet, we allow 1RU space per couple of batteries. When we get into the larger system, we allow 5RU per battery, because they may be under more load, a bit more airflow.
Yep.
But in this cabinet here, we can fit all the way up to, I think, 77 kilowatt hours of storage.
Oh, I see, this is for airflow. So
correct,
this is
yes.
with your blanked off RU.
Yep,
yeah.
Yep. So if we were in a larger capacity, we would have one of these for every battery module.
Right, yeah. So talking of airflow, I see that you've got fans on the front. Is
yes.
anything special about these?
One of the those contributing factors of making this a success and making sure it does work is closed loop cooling. So we've got no external air filters to worry about. So this is our heat exchanger heater option. Okay, so we're going to take cool air from the outside, cool fins, and then run our internal air over that. If you are in a hot climate, it's not a great deal more, and you can have a DC powered air conditioner in the door.
So being a heat exchanger, you're not blowing dusty air from the outside, trying to filter it and blow it into the cabinet.
That's a maintenance item, filters. So we eliminate that by having a heat exchanger.
Ah.
And all this air in here, the day the installer closes that door, to the day they open it, there should be no fresh air in there whatsoever.
Which also helps with humidity. So you're not going to change the humidity and dew point. And
correct, yep. Which is a good point to raise,
All right. Now, what about communication? I notice you've got this little screen up here. What's this smart pack?
Smart pack two touch screen. So going back to our remote hand style thing, anything you can do on this screen to control this can be remotely accessible.
Yep.
So us in Sydney, the team there can also help and connect to that to make any changes or check if anything needs to be done, push firmware updates to the batteries, the modules, check on everything. And this is the brain. It's going to control everything. So built into this, we also have generator control, start, battery charger for the generator. If we have a module go offline, then it will reconfigure all the other modules to start working properly. And of course, when we put a new module in, be it battery or module rectiverters, it will bring them online to the configuration that's set.
So the hot swappability is intelligent hot swap.
Yes.
It identifies it, brings it into the right phase, and
yes,
et cetera.
Yes, absolutely, yeah.
Oh, all right. Now, you mentioned generators too. I noticed that you've got a generator controls here.
Yes.
You've also got monitoring of the generator.
Yeah, so we can, if we use a particular compatible generator, we can monitor a lot of it with comms. Most common is we can provide a fuel sender, so you can monitor your fuel levels, and of course, we've got the start stop of that as well built in. So the compatible generators will give you a little bit more information, but you're not restricted to just our generators that we recommend.
So in terms of markets for this, where do you see this being used?
I think it's pretty diverse. I think there's a real market space for those companies that need to expand their business into the off-grid. They might not have the headcount or resources to assemble the traditional methods. Hot climates where you're going to need cooling rather than making a container and air conditioners. But I also see locations with very poor quality energy coming to the site, split phase or single phase, and they might need three phase on that site. So let's give them single phase grid energy, heap of solar batteries, and let's give them that three phase power out. Could connect the three phase generator as well. And I think there's going to be a market where we're going to need EV chargers in remote locations, and the infrastructure just can't deliver on it. So our EV product, this, skid, and we can deliver it remotely.
Well, that's a great segue to talk about your EV product, but we've got Cal for that, so maybe we're going to have a chat to Cal.
Sounds great.
Thank you.
Thanks,
Shane.
Cheers.
See ya.